Big Talk is sort of a personal triumph for me because it started with a trashy beat that I made on Reason, which is kind of a, you know, a little bit of a ghetto program. And I wrote the verse about 8 months before I ended up writing the chorus. So I literally took an old beat and set it to a new chorus part that was written by my friend Billy and Rennie. And we kind of just like Frankensteined this song. And this, as soon as I wrote the chorus, I knew that like something amazing and new had happened. And I thought it sounded like a psychotic circus of sarcasm. So that was super fun, and it was really irreverent and helpful for me at the time because I was just dealing with a lot of crap, as I try not to cuss. A lot of false, you know, vibes, people, promises, whatever that you encounter in life, and especially in Los Angeles. And, you know, the song's about that, and it's about being a human and not a douche. Big Talk. Killer is one of my favorite songs I've ever written. In a way, it's about a relationship, but it's also, like every relationship, is really about yourself, and the messages usually go both ways. So that song was really important to me at that time, and it all came in one shot, which is really rare. Just inspiration hits, you sit down, you write something, you leave that day and the song's written and you love it. Doesn't really happen that often, so I got really lucky with that one. Hustler is amazing because it's really a visceral, emotional, very specific, straightforward expression of how I feel on any given day, just trying to kind of make it through life on the planet. And really it's about having multiple personalities and having to do just about anything you have to do to make it happen, whatever that is for you. So I think it's really relatable kind of to anybody that's just working hard and, you know, making it up as they go along. Shape-shifting to get your stroll on you. Take Me Back, I really felt rounded out the EP because it's none of what the other three songs are. It's really emotional in a very candid, raw, open, kind of heartbreaking way. And that's hard for me to do. So I was happy that I could let that go down and that I stood behind it, and I did that vocal in one take in the basement of my friend's weird Hollywood apartment. And after we were done, I did it three times, and then he just kind of looked at me and was like, "I'm gonna cry, you have to leave." So I left, and we ended up using that vocal on the EP. Love is dead.